Nearly 34 years after Pan Am Flight 103 exploded over Lockerbie, Scotland, another person is being held accountable.
The fact that it took 34 years, I think, is a long time, but it's not the kind of thing you would have expected to happen quickly either.
The Justice Department announcing today that Abu Ajila Massoud, a Libyan man accused of making the bomb, will face federal charges in connection with the attack. U.S. officials announced charges against Massoud in 2020 when he was in Libyan custody and say now he's been apprehended. Two other men were charged 19 years ago. One was acquitted and the other was sentenced to 27 years in prison. Pan Am Flight 103 was New York bound when it blew up on December 21, 1988, less than an hour after taking off. 259 people on board and 11 others on the ground were killed. 190 of the victims were Americans, including two New Hampshire natives, pilot James McQuarrie and Syracuse student Stephen Boland. Boland was one of 35 students who were returning home from studying abroad.
He was overseas studying Shakespeare.
Turan Ergin had been in London studying theater. His brother Tosin, who lives in Wyndham, says Turan went to Syracuse to play sports, but after an injury, came back as a theater major.
He was a pretty remarkable kid.
The two brothers were 6 years apart in age, so they didn't hang out in school. But 1 year before the crash, they spent a week together skiing in Canada. Tosin's family also visited the memorial in Scotland this past summer.
That was really special.
In a statement, the Syracuse chancellor said in part, quote, "The Syracuse University community stands with all the victims' families, friends, and loved ones who have continued to seek justice for more than three decades. We remain steadfast in our commitment to remember, honor, and reflect on the legacy of the lives lost." In Manchester, Hannah Cotter, WMUR News 9.